Namaste. Hi guys, so I'm not going to do a vlog or a cover or anything today. I'm just going to be talking to you. I'm going to share one of my testimonies that happened really recently. And yeah, so I really hope that whoever hears this message just really hears me and hears God speaking through me. So I'm going to start us off with just a little prayer to God. So if you want to close your eyes or pray or be comfortable as you will, I'm going to pray. Dear Jesus, I just pray that your words flow through me today as I speak to my audience and your audience, your wonderful masterpieces. I hope that they retain this message and information as something that changed my life and something that could change others' lives too. God, I pray that you bless those in suffering and trial right now, and that you guide them to your glory, Lord, because glory to God in the highest. God, you're just so good, and I just can't help but thank you for everything that you've done for me and for people that I've seen move because of you. I'm moved because of you, and I pray that you keep doing your amazing work and shining light through the darkness. Amen. So, I went to Winter Retreat, which is basically a getaway from all the distractions, schoolwork, just things that you have daily in your life. So you get away, you go to camp with your church and another church or other churches, and you spend time connecting with others and unifying and uniting with each other through all the diverse circumstances. And you be in a relationship with God. You focus on your relationship with God, and you just let him move through you, and you let go of everything, and you say, I will follow you, Lord. I will be with you. I will be obedient. I will be an obedient child of God. And so I went to Winter Retreat thinking, oh, this is going to be like any other camp trip. I'm going to hear messages and not be changed. I felt like I was just going to go to have fun, get away from school, you know, distractions of life, great. But I didn't feel like I was going to have a bonding time with God and others due to past trials of my life. So a couple months ago, I lost two of my very dear friends because of some circumstances that they didn't approve of. And so we just had a big fight, and I couldn't take feeling like the relationship was one-sided. Well, the friendship was one-sided. And that I was just giving so much, and I couldn't possibly give any more. And they weren't giving anything back in return. So I had to cut it off and give it to God and see what he's going to do with my life. And so I let it go. But I didn't fully understand what letting all of that go meant. So I went to Winter Retreat thinking, well, maybe this will help me get back to my old self. Maybe I will have some new friends. I will be out there and try to make myself worthy and holy in people's eyes. And so I decided, well, let's go to Winter Retreat. And so I went, and I met amazing people. But the first, like, day and a half, I felt like I had to prove myself to others. I had to prove myself to God that I was here for the right circumstances, and that I didn't want anything in it for me, but for my relationship with God. And so I just kept, I'm never competitive, if you know me at all. I am not competitive at all. But this whole weekend, I was so competitive because I felt like I had to prove my worth to others. Like I mattered, like I was something. And the speaker, JC, she spoke at chapel, I think, like the second night. And she said that we are holy, that we already are holy because Jesus died on the cross for us. and that makes us holy. There are different interpretations of holy. And so what I thought my interpretation was, purity, I need to be perfect. I need to be perfect in the arms of the Father. My intentions need to be right with God. And us humans cannot physically be possible, cannot physically possibly be perfect, because Jesus Christ, God, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, is perfect. There is nothing more perfect. And so that really rang with me, and I heard it, I listened. It didn't go in one out ear and out the other. I listened to JC's words, I listened to God speak through her. And I heard, Chloe, just give it up. You can't do this on your own. There was no way you could have. I'm not expecting you to. I want to hold your hand and put my arms out and say, Chloe, just come. Come to me. And so I went to Jesus that night. I prayed to God. I said, I let go of everything. I give you all that I am, Lord. I want to be obedient. And so the last day, I made something out of it. I felt changed. I felt the Holy Spirit work through me. I felt God speak through me to others and guide me to His glory. Glory to God on the highest. And the last night was a bonfire. On fire in the middle of the night, stars, amazing. Not one cloud in this, well, maybe one cloud in the sky, but barely any clouds in the sky. Never seen a constellation before, and I look up, and I'm like, what? They are so beautiful, and I can't help but, I'm walking to the bonfire like this, just looking up at the stars like, could anything be more beautiful? God's creation is beautiful. I just can't help but rejoice. God is so good. And I start to cry. I see Orion's belt right up there. And I'm like, He placed every star in that sky, every tree in the ground, every creature walking on earth, every galaxy, every universe, His whole creation, majestic and beautiful as it is, He focuses on us. We weren't worthy. We aren't worthy of God's love, yet He still loves us, and He won't stop. God loves you. No matter what mistakes you've done, no matter how imperfect you are, you have flaws, but He loves you. He loves you. He focuses on us because we are made in His image. We are His masterpiece. And JC, she spoke. Another thing that she said on the second night was, as Christians, yes, we are God's masterpiece. We are created in His image, and therefore, we are the light in the darkness. We are shining. We're supposed to shine so bright for God's glory. But we can't shine bright if there is no darkness. Yes, we can shine. We can shine with the others and shine bright together. And that's what we're supposed to do, yes. But we're all supposed to shine in the darkness. We're supposed to be the light in the darkness. That doesn't mean the thing that everybody focuses on, although that's true in some cases, but it's supposed to be for God's glory. Light in the darkness, we're supposed to bring the joy, the peace, and definitely the hope of God's word to the people in the darkness. As Christians, we're called to do this. We're called to spread the love, spread God's good word, and hope that it reaches as many people as we can, because we just can't help but say thank you. Jesus died on the cross for us, and He loves us, and we just can't help but say thank you, Lord. I'm going to spread your love. I'm going to go over there and say, Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Because God loves you. all there is. They're all there ever was. Without God's love, without Jesus' love for us, there wouldn't be any of this. You see right through the mess inside. And so I left Winter Retreat changed. I left changed, completely changed. When I got home, I realized I see everything, all of this. My home, my way out of work, my way to school, every day. It all looks different. Why does it look different? Because my perspective changed on life. My perspective is changed forever. Because God is good. God is amazing. God created every single thing on this full creation. Everywhere. Everything. In cabin time at Winter Retreat, we were talking about how others have asked me and asked other Christians, how do you have so much faith? And a lot of people say the thing where it's like, you can't see gravity, but you know it's there. Yes, that is true. Yes, I can't see God physically. I can't see him physically. Like, he's not like right here, like, say, hi, Jesus. Nice to meet you. Yeah, like, I'm a big fan of you. I love you. Child of God, you love me. Like, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. No, I can't see him, but I see him. I have relationship with God. I understand who he is and what he wants for us. He wants us to love others, to love God, and to spread that love. So when my perspective changed, everything looks different. God is just so good. I'm thankful for everything. This house, I thought it was a dump. But look, I'm so fortunate to have things in my life, and I just can't help but thank God for what he put my family through and the circumstances that we are in. I'm so thankful. And I can't help but spread that love because I am so thankful. I'm thankful for my neighborhood, my school, my church, the body of Christ working together. JC also said on one of the nights, she said, yes, we are the body of Christ. Church is the body of Christ. And God is the head. We can't do it on our own. We can't say, feet, I don't need you. My hands can work alone. No, we need them. We need them to walk, to spread God's word. We're not just going to be doing handstands all the way to Africa, are we? No. God is so good. I can't help but let that ring. I can't. Hold on. I need to take my pizza thingies out of the oven. They look delicious. Okay, sorry. That is my lunch. I will be going to work after this, but I just can't help but spread God's love because I'm so thankful. Every day I used to go to work out at the school, go to work, come home, exhausted, pass out, tired, done, repeat. Work out at the school, work, come home, exhausted, pass out, repeat. That's all I would do. And I just couldn't help, but I lost the passion for Christ. I lost it. It's a Winter Retreat, and then I'm just like, God, you are the passion. You are my passion. I just need to reach out and say, Father, I ask you for your passion. I ask you for everything. Fill me with everything that you are. God, I want to be like you. I want to be Christ-like, and I long to be loved by you. And I am loved. I don't have to try. We don't have to work. Yes, our actions matter. Yes, we must live Christ-like. That's what Christianity means, to live like Christ, to make disciples of Christ. Spread the love. Feel God's love. Be in relationship with Christ and others. We are meant for relationships with others and Christ. Forgot where I was going with this. But we long to have a goal in life. Ever heard of the question, what is life? What would Christians say? They would say, Jesus. What is life? Jesus. What is the meaning of life? Jesus. Right? The meaning of life is Jesus Christ, because He saved us and made us live our lives. He helps us. He longs for us. He gave up His life to give me mine. Yesterday, on Shine 104.9 FM, they played three amazing songs. I can't remember the first two, but the last one was, with every heart beating my chest, Lord, I surrender all that I have. The day's yet to come, the day's even best. I'm giving you all I have with lifted hands. That song. Sorry, just broke out in song like high school musical. But that song, everything that I was going through, I cried in the car after work. I'm like, Jesus, I never did this alone. The funny thing is, when I lost my friends and I felt like I had nobody to support me, I never felt lonely. God was there with me. God is here with me. He's here, longing for me to just lay it at His feet. And so that's what I did last night. I laid it at Jesus Christ's feet and I said, Jesus, take it. Take it. I want to be like You, Lord. I want to be like You. And so I finally let go. I never knew what letting go was like until that very moment. My perspective changed. My life changed. I left Winter Retreat changed. Because God moved through me, moved through JC, moved through the others at that Winter Retreat to speak to me and to speak to others. And so now I can't help but preach and say thank You. Thank You, Lord, for everything that You've done for me. I feel lifted. I feel weightless. I don't feel judged by others because their judgment doesn't matter. Jesus Christ's judgment matters. God's judgment matters. I don't care what they have to say. I don't care what I have to say. If my God loves me, He loves me. I am loved. It doesn't matter what other people think. And to love myself, therefore I can love others. And spread God's love, to love myself, to love others, so that they can do the same. So I don't know where you're at right now. Maybe you're going through trials. Maybe you're having the best time in your life you've had in forever. Or maybe this is the first time that you've actually had it good. But wherever you are, just let God speak through you. Be obedient to God, because He longs for you with arms wide open, saying, come, come into my arms. Just come. Lay all of the struggles at my feet. Give it up. You can't do it on your own. That's why I'm here. That's why I gave you my life, so that you could have yours. It's so unusual. deciding to follow Jesus and make this change in my life and be a changed person is the one decision I will never regret. Ever. God, I pray that whoever sees this message really hears you and longs for you with lifted hands, arms wide open, and that they follow you, Jesus. I hope that they know that you are the living and breathing hope of this world, the only hope. God, I pray that they feel your love and they feel loved by you. That they learn to love themselves and to love others, to spread that love because they just can't help but thank you for your love. God, pray for the broken hearts, grieving ones, that they come to you, Lord, and cry. They praise you that they got to know them, that they have to know you, they get to know you. Jesus, I pray for those lifted hearts. I pray for the joyful ones and that they continue to feel your peace and your joy and that they are saved by grace. Jesus, I pray this all in your heavenly, amazing, wonderfully beautiful and powerful name. I hope you've heard God's word through this, through me, today. So do what you can with it. Let your heart be changed. If you can, I don't care about the likes, but if you want to, like, comment. If you want to comment, you can follow my Instagram or my Snapchat or something. I love prayer requests, so if you need me to pray for you, just tell me. Amen.